Hello there, friends, and welcome to another What's for Dinner video. So on Sunday, we had beanie weenies. Now, that might just be what we call them in the South. I don't know if that's a thing anywhere else, but I am making a homemade version of that, and it's pretty much really good baked beans with smoked sausage in them, or some people just use hot dog wieners, but I'm using little smokies because we like the flavor of those better. So I am opening up just a regular old can of baked beans, and I'm adding those chopped smoked sausages to it, some dried minced onion, some onion powder, some garlic powder, some barbecue sauce. I did about a cup of barbecue sauce. You can do more or less depending on what you like. And some brown sugar, probably about 3 tablespoons, a few more onion flakes, and some bacon bits. And we're just gonna give that a good mix, and that's gonna cook on low in the crock pot for about 4 hours. And this is what it looks like when it's ready to go. It's super simple, super cheap, and super good. So if you've never tried these, I recommend trying them because they're one of our favorites. And who doesn't like a simple and cheap dinner? On Monday, we had beef quesadillas. I am just browning up some ground beef. I got this at Lidl. We had never tried this brand before, but I'm not really crazy picky about like brands of ground beef. I mean, if it looks fine, I'll buy it. You know, that's really how I go with that. But I am just browning the ground beef, drained off the grease. Now I'm adding some pepper, some onion powder, and some garlic powder. And then I'm gonna add in some taco seasoning. Now I make my own taco seasoning. You can just use a packet, but I just like making my own seasoning. So that's what I'm doing there. And I just add about 2/3 cup of water, and I just cook it until you can no longer see any water. And then I am going to remove that from the heat and shred some cheese. So I am just shredding some sharp cheddar cheese. I started on the big size and then went to the small one. I got that grater at the Dollar Tree, and I'm not a fan, honestly. But on my griddle, I just have a 6-inch tortilla, and I topped it with some taco sauce, some cheese, some ground beef, some more cheese, some more taco sauce, and then the top tortilla. Now, I really overestimated how much we would need because I'm like, well, these are kind of small, so I'll make myself 2 and I'll make Eric 3 and we'll be fine. But no, they were really filling. I ended up eating 1 and Eric ate like 1.5. So 1 is plenty for a person, but I ended up making 5 and we ate like 3. But it's okay. The leftovers were good. So here I'm just cutting them into 4 pieces, and I just served mine with some corn. Eric doesn't really like corn, so he just got quesadillas, but these were really good. It's kind of a different way to jazz up your normal like taco dinner, so I say try it. Tacos are one of my husband's favorite dinners, so he really, really liked these, and yeah, they were really easy to put together and really simple. On Tuesday, we had some bacon-wrapped kielbasa with some cabbage and some rice. Here, this is the night before. I'm just getting this cabbage ready to go in the crock pot. I'm just chopping up a whole head of cabbage, adding that to the crock pot. And then I'm also going to chop up an onion and add that to the crock pot as well. Again, anything that's going in my crock pot, I like getting it ready the night before, and that way in the morning, all I have to do when I'm still sleepy and groggy is put it in the actual crock pot and turn it on. But I'm seasoning it up with some salt and some pepper, and I'm adding some bacon bits and a little bit of bacon grease just because I didn't have a lot of bacon bits. So I just add a little spoonful of that, and I don't usually buy chicken broth. I just use water and broth base. So I added 6 cups, and I ended up adding 2 more cups in the morning before I turned it on. So you'll see that here in a minute. But yeah, I just like to get everything ready to go. So in the morning, all I have to do is turn it on. So the next morning, when I was putting it in my crock pot, I added a little bit of butter and some garlic because I forgot to do that the night before. And then I added that water because it looked kind of dry. But I just let it cook on low all day, and it was good to go when we got home. That's what it looked like. When we got home, my house stunk. If you ever cook cabbage at home, you know what I'm talking about. You walk in that door and it's just like, oh, not a pleasant smell, but the cabbage was good. It was worth it. But here I am just using this little package of seasoned rice that I picked up at Aldi for like I think it was like 88 cent or something. And I'm just putting what it said to do in a saucepan, but I just put it in the rice cooker because that's easier for me. And here I am just chopping up my kielbasa into little sections, and I'm going to start wrapping them in bacon. Now, this bacon was really thick. I think it would have actually turned out better if it had been a little thinner, but we just went with it. And I rolled them up in the bacon. They probably would have been a little easier to work with had I had toothpicks to like hold that bacon in place, but I did not have any. So after I got them wrapped up, I just put them like the loose side of the bacon down and put them in the air fryer. I let them go for about 20 minutes and I flipped them halfway through, and then I'm brushing the ones that I'm gonna eat in barbecue sauce. Eric didn't want any barbecue sauce on his, and I just let them go a couple minutes longer until that barbecue sauce thickened up. But here's what it looked like when it was ready to go. It was a really good meal. We really liked it, and we would definitely make it again. That cabbage was really good, even though it made my house stink, but it was a really good cabbage. We really enjoyed this meal a whole lot. And if you happen to make this, let me know in the comments how you like it. On Wednesday, we had chicken parmesan, so I'm just getting my little like egg mixture ready to go. So that's just eggs, some milk, some salt and pepper. And here I'm just seasoning up some all-purpose flour. I just did garlic powder, onion powder, Italian seasoning, some salt and pepper. And I'm giving that a mix, and I'm getting my breadcrumb mixture ready. So I have Italian seasoned breadcrumbs, and again, garlic powder, onion powder, salt, pepper, Italian seasoning. And also to that, I added some Parmesan cheese, the shredded kind and like the sprinkle kind. And this is what we're gonna bread our chicken in. So here I have three thinly sliced chicken breasts, and I'm just seasoning them up with some salt and pepper on each side. And I am going to dredge the chicken in the flour, then dip it into the egg wash mixture, and then roll it in the breadcrumbs. I'm going to do that to all three chicken breasts and put them into a skillet that has some canola oil that is just heated up. You want to make sure that oil is hot before you add your chicken so that it actually starts cooking it and getting crispy versus trying to like soak up that grease. So just make sure you preheat your oil, and it's not very much, just enough to cover the bottom of that skillet, just so that it has an even surface of oil for the chicken to cook in. Also on the stove, I have some salted water coming up to a boil, and I am just gonna boil some bow tie pasta. I was gonna do spaghetti, but I didn't have any, so bow ties it is. And in that cute little saucepan back there, I just have a jar of regular prepared pasta sauce. I'm doctoring it up a little bit. I'm just adding some onion powder, some garlic powder, and some Italian seasoning. And I'm also gonna add 2 little tablespoons of whipped cream cheese. And after that's all melted, I'm gonna add a splash of heavy cream. But meanwhile, I am just checking on my chicken, and I'm gonna check the temperature, and when it reaches 165 degrees, I will remove it to a paper towel lined plate and then let it chill for a minute while I'm waiting for the sauce to be done. And now I'm putting it in a oven safe dish, and I'm gonna top it with some Parmesan cheese, our creamy marinara sauce, and then some shredded mozzarella. I always shred my own cheese because I think it tastes so much better and melts so much better. And then I'm gonna put some more Parmesan. Now, I did not shred the Parmesan just because Parmesan is really hard to shred. But while that is broiling in the oven for a couple minutes, I added some butter to my pasta, which I have drained, and then some Parmesan cheese and some Italian seasoning. And that's all I added to this. I just moved it around until that butter was fully melted and the cheese started to melt. And this pasta was really good by itself, but even better with some of that creamy marinara sauce on top. I think I left the chicken on broil for about 5 or 6 minutes, and this is what it looked like when I took it out of the oven. This stuff looked so good. I was so ready to eat dinner, and this is what it looked like plated up. I just have the chicken with some of that pasta and the marinara sauce topped with some extra Parmesan cheese, and then my husband just has the chicken because he's not big on pasta, believe it or not. Yeah, I don't know what's wrong with him either, but this was a great dinner, and we will definitely make it again. It was so good. Now, on Thursday, this was a complicated recipe, so y'all listen up. I threw some weenies into the air fryer, some canned chili into the microwave, and that was it. I did not feel like cooking, and I just had this stuff on hand. So I'm like, okay, hot dogs, that'll take me 5 minutes. And that's what we had for dinner. So we had hot dogs. I didn't make anything to go with them. So my husband has three, I have two. And that was dinner after a really busy day at work. Sometimes you just need something quick and effortless. So that's what this night was. And on Friday, I made us a steak dinner. So this is the night before. I am getting me a marinade ready. So I have some olive oil, some lemon juice, some Worcestershire sauce, some soy sauce, some basil, some garlic powder, some pepper, and some hot sauce, and a scoop of garlic. I will leave the amounts and everything linked below. I did half of the recipe because I was only marinating two steaks, but I put that in my little food chopper, gave it a little buzz, and now I'm just putting my steaks in there, covering it with a marinade, and that's gonna go into the fridge overnight. Next, I am getting my potatoes ready. The only part I didn't show, which I went back and did later because I forgot to when I was filming this, was I went back and poked my potatoes a couple of times with a fork so they would cook faster, but I am brushing the outside of the potatoes with some melted bacon grease, and I'm just sprinkling them with some salt and pepper and rolling them in tin foil. These will go in a 400 degree oven for about an hour, sometimes a little longer, but you just let them go until your potatoes are tender, and that is that. So here I am getting my steaks ready to cook. I am just putting them on paper towels and patting them dry. I let the steaks sit out for a few minutes to come to room temperature before I start cooking them. But after I pat them dry, I just put some salt and pepper on both sides. And in my skillet, I am putting a few tablespoons of butter, and that's gonna melt. Over there, what I'm doing now was putting bacon in there because I realized I didn't have any more bacon bits, and we definitely needed some bacon for our potatoes. But I'm just getting that butter melted, and I'm going to add my steaks to those, and I'm gonna let them go on like medium high heat for about 4 minutes. I'm not moving them, not touching them, nothing. Just let them sit there. After that time is up, you're just gonna flip over your steaks, top them with some butter, and put them into a 350 degree oven for about 5 minutes. Now I am shredding some cheese for our salads that I made and for our baked potatoes. And then I'm also taking that bacon that I cooked while my steaks were cooking and chopping that up for the potatoes and the salads as well. This is what the steaks look like when they come out of the oven. I am just putting them on a plate and burning my hand because I forgot that pan was hot. But I covered it with some tin foil and let it rest for about 5 minutes. And this is what it looked like when it was done. Like, who needs a steakhouse when you can make this at home? This was a really good dinner. We really enjoyed it. And that was the last dinner for this week. So that wraps up another week of dinners. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. And I'll see you in the next one.